Welcome back to Coulter Company, and prepare yourselves. For close on 40 years, my next guest has roared across the charts like Santa Claus on a Harley Davidson. But wasn't only music and songs, they weren't his only gifts. This man really, really is a whirlwind of entertainment. Nobody sleeps when this guy is on. The legendary and notorious Roy Wood!
It's really cool. Well, if the band starts playing, there's a jukebox in the hall. With your booty song and your folks all gone, you sure get the guys buzzed. Yeah, that real guitar boy shaking. I'm a California man. That's right, on till the phones are breaking. Making me mad. Well, I don't care if the legs start again. I'm a California man. Woo. Ooh, my legs start shivering when I hear you call my name. Yeah, my knees keepin' ugly and the things I'm ugly man. When I drink too fast, my cheeks hung away down low. Back of my heels, it's a making me feel like a king of rock and roll. Get that real guitar boy shaking. I'm a California man. That's right on till the folks are breaking. I'm a California man. Yeah, rock my mama's new bed. This a woman, she's a making me mad. Well, I don't care if the legs start again. I'm a California man.
Roy.
Phil, I've never seen you in a suit, mate. I posh as that.
Well, I thought it would impress you, Roy. You're celebrating nearly 40 years in this business. You keep telling me that's not because you're old, it was just that you started very young.
Yes, I started at three.
No.
That was me dad. That was me dad that had all the hits.
Tell me, I'm genuinely interested. What age were you when you had your first hit?
Well, I was in a band when I was 14, doing clubs and stuff, and I had my first hit when I was 17.
Which was?
With a move, which is Night of Fear.
Night of Fear?
Yeah.
And then?
And then after that was I Can Hear the Grass Grow, Then Flowers in the Rain, The Fire Brigade. Well, they went few other.
But now, don't go past them so quickly, because I want to nail a few of these. Would I be right in saying the Fire Brigade was the first one that gave us a glimpse of what we should expect from Roy Wood in the next 20 years?
Rock and roll type thing. Probably. In fact, I wrote that in a bit of a rush, because even though we'd already had like 3 hit records then, we still couldn't afford to have separate bedrooms in hotels.
Right.
We're still like ganging up in rooms and that. Right. And the manager came up to me and said, right, we're in the studio tomorrow at 10:30 in the morning. We need you to write a song.
And we can't waste money or time, so we have to have the song, right?
So gave me my own key to my own room and a bottle of booze and said, get on with it. So I wrote all night, and the band came in about 8:30 in the morning and joined in with the chorus and all that kind of thing.
And then they had
to wheel me into the studio, because I was like, wow, I was just, you know, I was so knackered and I was gone by then, you know.
That was
Fire Brigade.
First of the Roy Wood rockers.
Oh, yeah.
Cast your mind back 10 years to the girl who's next to me at school. If I put my hand upon her leg, she'd hit me with a rule. Though tomorrow won't be long, you gotta have to play it cool. You'd be fascinated by her, she could set the place afire.
The chorus.
Run and get the Fire Brigade, get the Fire Brigade. See the building start to really burn. Get the Fire Brigade, get the Fire Brigade. If you jump, you've got to wait your turn.
Yeah. There he goes into the rock and roll bit.
What a madness. There are a lot of people, Roy, who wouldn't realise that you were, this after the move, that you were one of the architects of ELO.
Yeah.
Tell me about those days.
Yeah, well, what happened... during the recording of, there was a Move album, which needed more than just guitars and drums on. Okay. And Tony Visconti was working with us then as an arranger, mm-hmm. rather than a producer. Mm-hmm. And he wrote some nice string parts to my songs. And I thought, wouldn't it be nice to actually get a band together of young people that play classical instruments? Rather than putting an advert in the paper for a guitarist or whatever. Mm-hmm. How about a French horn player or a cellist or something, get a whole thing together? But it was more difficult than you would think in those days to get people that wanted to go on tour, you know, I mean, they weren't really into it. So I'd been friends with Jeff Lynne for a while, because I used to play in a band called Mike Sheridan and the Nightriders, mm-hmm. which later changed the name to the Arden Race, and Jeff sort of took my place when I left. And we've been friends ever since. And I knew that Jeff was a very good songwriter, and I thought it might be easier to get a band like that together with 2 writers rather than 1. And I approached Jeff about it, and he agreed to join the Move at the end of its days, so that we could get ELO together, basically.
And just transferring.
We went into that, yeah.
That was breaking a lot of new ground.
Breaking a lot of new ground.
But then you moved on from then to the musical mayhem of Wizzard, when they used with your makeup and your costumes. They used to call you an accident from the paint shop. They were colourful days. Was that the best fun of all?
It was a lot of fun. I mean, the way that image came about is towards the end of the Move, we had a record out called Brontosaurus. Mm-hmm. And this girl made me an outfit, which was a sort of black and white triangles coat. It was like a wizard coat, but mm-hmm. black and white. And we did the old grey whistle test, we were on that. And I got some black and white makeup and made my face up to match my jacket.
Right.
And that's how it all started.
That was the start.
Yeah, it was the start of it. And towards the end of the Move, we did quite a few festivals, and I kept that image until the end of that. And then after we'd done ELO and I'd left, I thought, well, it would be nice to resurrect that image for Wizzard, but make it brighter. It's the same thing, but like multicoloured.
Wow. But no. Whatever about that. This may be the height of the summer, Roy, but there is no way that I am letting you out of this building without doing the Christmas anthem. This is...
Ow!
Yeah, you got to do it. You just got... I'm not going to take no for an answer. You got to do this.
I'll do a bit of it. Do you want to sing the chorus with me?
You.
Of course you do. Just bloody do it, all right?
But when the snowman brings the snow, well, he just might like to know. When you jump into your bed, quickly cover up your head. But don't you lock the doors, you know the sweet Santa Claus is on the way.
All together.
Well, I wish it could be Christmas every day. When the kids start singing and the band begins to play. Well, I wish it could be Christmas every day. Let the bells ring out for Christmas. Why don't you give your love for Christmas?
So that one starts.
That's classic, classic song. Roy Wood.
Yeah, cheers.
Good one, Roy. Good songs, good music, good company. I hope you've enjoyed that bit of musical mayhem this evening, and it'll be back to see us next week. Going to leave you now with Roy and one of his classics, Blackberry Way.
Thank you. Thank you, Phil. Please join in with this one.
Blackberry Way, absolutely pouring down with rain. It's a terrible day, off with the lark. Was running away, so now I'm standing on the corner, lost in the things that I said. What am I supposed to do now?
All together.
Goodbye, Blackberry Way. I can see you. I don't need you. Goodbye, Blackberry Way. Despite myself, the unexpected turn with my eyes to the wall. What am I supposed to do now?
Come on!
Goodbye, Blackberry Way.
Come on!
I can't see you. I don't need you. Goodbye, Blackberry Way. Should you want me back another day? Come on. Goodbye.